Are you frustrated by your struggle to conceive again, despite having had one or possibly more children in the past? But now it's just not happening again. Why is that? Well, if that's you, this video is for you. In this video, we will address multiple reasons that make it difficult for you to fall pregnant again, despite having children in the past. So keep watching. Hi, I'm Dr. Kady, a former pharmacist, currently practicing as a fully certified family doctor with a special interest in women's health and fertility. The inability to conceive or to carry a pregnancy to term after having one or more children is called secondary infertility. This can be challenging physically and emotionally for both partners. Several factors contribute to secondary infertility. Let's look at them individually. The first is age. As a woman gets older, both the quantity and the quality of her eggs decline. And this has a significant impact on both the ability to conceive, but also to carry the pregnancy full term. Age as a factor that impacts fertility is true for both primary and secondary infertility. Primary infertility defines never having fallen pregnant or carried full term. Then there are ovulatory disorders. Irregular ovulation or the lack of ovulation altogether means that an egg is not being released from the ovaries in order to be fertilized by the sperm. And so if you are not ovulating and you are not releasing again, you won't be able to conceive. This is often seen in the condition known as polycystic ovarian syndrome, PCOS. Okay, let's look at this practically. If you were already given a diagnosis of PCOS, but you still managed to conceive previously, it may well be because your hormonal balance wasn't too deranged at the time. But now, if you are struggling to conceive a few years, or in some cases, some months down the line, this may be explained by the fact that your hormonal balance is now significantly disturbed. And as a result, you are just not releasing any eggs from your ovaries. Another important cause is uterine and tubal issues, the most common one being uterine fibroids. For example, if you were told that you had a uterine fibroid and in your previous pregnancy it was small enough and not causing any problems and you were able to carry to term, a few years down the line, it may be that that uterine fibroid has gotten bigger or you have developed a few more fibroids. So what happens is once the egg is fertilized in the fallopian tube and it starts to make its way further down the uterus in order for implantation to happen, if you have certain fibroids that affect the integrity of the endometrium may prevent the implantation of the fertilized egg from happening. Although you had fibroids before and they were never a problem, you may have developed a few more of different characteristics and at different positions in your uterus, or the previous fibroids that you had have just gotten bigger. If you were told that you had fibroids before and you are now struggling to conceive, an important thing that you must do is to get an ultrasound to know the current state of the fibroids that you had. Even if you were told that you didn't have fibroids before, now that you're struggling to conceive again, it is well worth having an ultrasound to find out if you have developed fibroids. Just so that we're all on the same page, fibroids are non-cancerous growth that happen in the uterus of a woman of childbearing age. Other uterine and tubal causes of secondary infertility include endometriosis and pelvic inflammatory disease. Endometriosis is a condition in which the endometrium, which is the lining that is normally found inside of the womb, in this condition is found outside of the womb and in parts of the pelvic anatomy where it should not be found. Pelvic inflammatory disease is infection leading to inflammation of the female reproductive system. Both of these conditions cause secondary infertility because they cause adhesion and scarring in the pelvis, as well as distorting the anatomy of the uterus and the fallopian tubes. When these conditions are not treated and addressed, they can lead to significant inflammation happening in the uterus. This inflammation prevents implantation of the fertilized egg. And these conditions, when left untreated, can go as far as causing a reduced ovarian reserve. Therefore, because you have less eggs in your ovaries, you may not be ovulating. Hence, the struggle to conceive again. scar tissues. If you have had previous pelvic surgeries, the classical one being cesarean sections, especially if you've had multiple cesarean sections, it will lead to tough fibrous tissues being formed in the pelvic area, but more specifically as it relates to secondary infertility, this scar tissue forms within your uterus. By the way, this scar tissue can also develop if you have had pelvic inflammatory disease or sexually transmitted diseases that were either not treated or were treated too late. And the way that this scar tissue can prevent you from getting pregnant again by causing lots of adhesions in the fallopian tubes. So if your fallopian tubes have lots of adhesions, they become blocked. So although you are releasing eggs from your fallopian tubes, the eggs that you are releasing during ovulation just cannot get past this tough fibrous tissue that is found in the fallopian tubes. The scar tissue also prevents the sperm cells from getting to the fallopian tube where it can fertilize the egg that has been released. Scar tissue changes the pelvic anatomy. It changes the normal position of the reproductive organ as well as affects its mobility. Also, if you have scarring around the ovaries, it may go as far as preventing ovulation from happening. Finally, an important risk of having pelvic adhesions is the increased risk of developing an ectopic pregnancy. This is simply when the fertilized egg implants outside of the uterus, most commonly when it implants within the fallopian tube itself. And this condition is life-threatening. An important thing for me to mention about an ectopic pregnancy is that if you have actively been trying to get pregnant and therefore you're not using any contraception and you're getting a sudden onset of severe pelvic pain, it's important that you present to a clinician immediately and let them know that you are trying to get pregnant and query whether this may be a sign of an ectopic pregnancy. It's important that you prompt your doctor about this condition because it can easily be missed and has led to the loss of lives of some women. Hormonal imbalances. In addition to the hormonal imbalance that is seen in patients who have PCOS, there is also the hormonal imbalance that is seen in patients with thyroid disease. The thyroid hormone is important in regulating the metabolism and the normal functioning of different systems in the body. This includes the normal functioning of the reproductive system. So proper functioning of the thyroid hormone is important. Otherwise, if the thyroid hormone is not working properly, what will happen is that you start to have irregular periods will be followed by irregular ovulation, or sometimes no ovulation at all for several months. This means it becomes very difficult for you to predict your fertile window. So if you're struggling to fall pregnant again, despite having previous successful pregnancies and having one or more children, the fact that you're struggling to fall pregnant again this time may be an indication that you have developed thyroid disease. And once you're on your way to being treated successfully, conception should happen quite easily. If you do have thyroid disease and you somehow manage to get pregnant, not treating your thyroid disease increases your risk of a miscarriage. If you are struggling to fall pregnant again, also look at male infertility factors. In men, thyroid disease affects the production of sperm cells. Hypothyroidism in particular affects the quality and the quantity of the sperm cells that are produced. As well as ruling out thyroid disease for yourself as a woman, it's important you do so together with your partner to make sure that he doesn't have thyroid disease that is affecting his ability to produce good, healthy, and mobile sperm cells. Then we have significant changes in weight, either significant weight gain or significant weight loss. These affect the hormonal balance and can disrupt the menstrual cycle, ultimately impacting ovulation. Finally, there are lifestyle factors such as excessive stress, excessive consumption of alcohol, smoking, and exposure to environmental toxins such as BPA, which is found in the plastic containers, and this substance can leak into the food and drink that we consume. That affects the quality of the eggs that we produce, or in men can affect the quality and the quantity of the sperm cells. All of these lifestyle factors can be the reasons why you are struggling to fall pregnant again. I end these videos by giving you hope and building your faith through sharing the word of God with you. I'll be sharing from Romans chapter 4, verses 18 to 22. Against all hope, Abraham in hope believed and so became the father of many nations, just as it had been said to him, so shall your offspring be. Without weakening in his faith, he faced the fact that his body was as good as dead, since he was about 100 years old, and that Sarah's womb was also dead. Yet he did not waver through unbelief regarding the promise of God, but was strengthened in his faith and gave glory to God, being fully persuaded that God had power to do what he had promised. This is why it was credited to him as righteousness. Stay strong as you go through your journey of trying to conceive, and I'm believing with you that it will happen. Take care, and we'll see you in our next video.